Hey there, my name is Sam. In this video, we are going to go over how to appeal your Google Business Profile suspension. So if your Google Business Profile has been suspended, these are the steps you should take if you want to appeal it and so that it is not suspended and you can move on with your life. What we're going to cover, how to appeal using Google's online form, filing a second appeal if denied. There's two URLs for this and they're different. Common suspension reasons to avoid, and then things to be mindful of for a successful reinstatement. So real quickly, let's get started here. If you have questions, leave them in the comments and I will try to get back to them. So I'm filming this in June of 2025. And if you have received an email that looks like this, your business profile has been suspended. You obviously don't want it suspended. And so you need to take some steps to get it appealed and unsuspended. So a couple things to be mindful of. There have been more suspensions that are happening. A lot of this is because people tried to bend the rules or set up fake profiles to improve their local SEO. And so there's more suspensions, there's more appeals, that's kicked the timeline now. It can take up to 5 weeks. Usually I see this go quicker than that, but just be mindful. It can take some time to do that because there's more businesses that are being affected. If your profile has been suspended, pause on making changes to it. Or even if your profile is not suspended, one of the reasons it can be suspended is if you're making a lot of changes quickly. Sometimes that can trigger a suspension. So just be mindful of that. Ideally, once you get it set up, you do it right the first time, and then you're making occasional changes as you go. Why was your profile suspended? Be prepared to be frustrated by this and to not have a clear answer. Again, you'll get an email like this, and then it'll tell you the violation type. And so in this case, content that violates our policies on deceptive content and behavior. This is a profile that we work with. It's a real business with a real office. There haven't been, there were no overt policy violations that I was aware of, but it still got suspended, so now we have to deal with it. But even this, it doesn't tell you hey, what was the content that was deceptive. It just tells you there was deceptive content. So then you're like, okay, well, that's not super helpful, especially if you were trying to do things the right way. So that's frustrating, but it is what it is. So now let's move on to the actual appeal process. A couple things to be mindful of. You have two appeal opportunities, but again, there's different URLs to go to, and they don't make it super easy to find that, which is why I'm making this video. Once you submit an appeal, you have 60 minutes to submit evidence, so you want to have that ready beforehand. And there's an appeals tool or form, and we'll go through that. You can submit what's the general timeline? You submit the appeal, you can do that right away. You have 60 minutes to add the evidence. Plan on 4 to 5 weeks, hopefully it goes quicker. And then if your first appeal is denied, there is an opportunity to do a second appeal. Be aware, again, you have 60 minutes to add evidence, so have your evidence ready before you get started, just so that you have it ready and you don't miss out on that window. So the first thing you're going to do is to appeal it. Now, if you get an email, there'll be a button there that says appeal. If you lost that email or whatever, you can go to this URL. I have no idea why they don't make this cleaner, but that is what it is. And it's going to look something similar to this, where you move myself out of the way here, but you confirm your account. So you want to make sure you're signed into the correct account. Then you click confirm. Then it's going to give you a list of business profiles under that account, and you need to select the one that was suspended and click continue. And there's just a few more continue buttons there, but you just follow that form. Again, make sure you're signed into the correct account. Make sure that you select the business profile that was suspended. Just be mindful of that. So you just follow through that, and there's just going to be a couple questions. You click continue. Then at the end, you will be able to submit your evidence. And so I'll look at that in a second, but you can review why it was suspended. Click the circle boxes, just make your way through that. Click continue, that's gonna submit the appeal, and then you have 60 minutes to submit evidence here. So on the evidence submission piece, what they want is documents that show basically your business name and the address. And so some of the documents that you can submit, And this, I say required here, these are helpful documents. Technically, you could submit an appeal and not submit evidence. It's just as helpful if you do. But like business registration and license, tax certificates, utility bills, again, business license, just anything that would have your business name and the address, and that name and address need to match what is on your Google Business profile. If you are submitting documents that don't have the same name or address, like that's not going to help your case. So you go through all that process, and then if that is still denied, you can submit a second appeal. This URL is slightly cleaner, but it's support.google.com/business/contact/local-appeals. This one is going to look like this. And again, it's just a form that you will fill out, and it's requesting an additional review of a denied appeal. You can click, first you have to have submitted an appeal through that first method. If you did that, click yes. Was it denied? Yes. You can get the dates and your business profile ID and so forth. And then you can, again, submit some evidence here. You can upload multiple files. Make a note on why you shouldn't be suspended, and then click submit. That's how you submit the second appeal. If you're doing everything the right way, like this should get approved, but you go through all of that, fill out the form with the required information, and then click submit, and you're on your way. Now, things to be mindful of as you're doing this. So common reasons that a profile would be suspended, keywords in the business name. Your business name should match the exact name of your business, the legal entity. If you want to include keywords in it, go ahead and get a DBA and have the DBA have the keywords in it. But if you don't have the DBA and then you're trying to fit keywords into your business name and you don't have that, it's you're gonna probably be suspended and you won't win your appeal. Incorrect or virtual addresses, so PO boxes, things like that, we'll take a look at that in a second. Inconsistent NAP data, so that's name, address, phone number. If you have one address on your Google Business profile but it's not matching on your website, you'd want to get that cleaned up. Suspicious activity, that could be, I mean, that's so vague, but it could be one of your putting up fake stuff on your profile, if you have fake reviews on your profile, if you're making a ton of changes very quickly, all of that could trigger a suspension. When you get suspended, it's not like a person at Google is sitting there and it's like, I'm going to suspend this person. It's all automated. And so it's just, if you make an action that triggers the algorithm, that's why you're getting suspended there. Content violations, that's going to vary by the business type that you're in. High risk categories, these are ultimately ones that, you know, people, they're competitive areas, so people try to bend the rules more. Lawyers, plumbers, HVAC companies, locksmiths, electricians, home services, a lot of the really popular local SEO kind of categories and businesses there, you'll see usually more suspensions in that. But again, like business name violations, that's a big one. So here's some notes on that. Keywords in the business name, top violation. So what not to do. If your business is named Mario's Pizza, don't name it Best Pizza Near Me. If you are, and this one's maybe not the greatest example, but if you're a real estate agent, like John Smith Realtor, real estate agent, kind of keyword stuffing there as opposed to just the name John Smith or John Smith Realtor or whatever. NYC Plumbing Service as opposed to Smith Plumbing, Downtown Auto Repair Shop as opposed to Mike's Auto. You want your actual business name. Again, you can have a name like this. Just make sure you get a DBA, and then once you have that, then you can submit that DBA documentation and do that. And from a local SEO perspective, I actually would recommend getting a DBA, because at the moment, exact match keywords do rank better, and it just is what's going on there. So what do you want to do, though? Say you get suspended. Make sure that your business name and the documentation matches the business name of the Google Business profile. It all needs to be consistent. Have storefront signage if you have an actual office. Be able to, have a picture of that, upload that as documentation, and you just want it consistent. And again, like, don't try to cheat the system. Cheat the system the right way. So if you're going to have Downtown Auto Repair Shop, make sure you get a DBA for that, and then you can, play by the rules and not get suspended, but still have that advantage from the local keyword there. Address related violations, things to be mindful of, PO boxes, USP store, USP UPS store addresses, virtual offices, co-working spaces. These two almost are always getting flagged now. The virtual offices and co-working spaces, those can work. It is helpful if you have a permanent office, if you have signage that's up there. Sometimes you could roll the dice and try it. I do see, I've even had myself UPS store addresses that have worked, but those are getting flagged more. So just be mindful of that. Worst case scenario, use your home address and be a service area business if you really don't have another address to use there. All right, some tips for success. Before you get started on the appeal, have all of your documentation ready. That way you can just submit it right away. Fix any violations before appealing. So like if your business name is using keywords in it that aren't a part of your business name, update that first, then submit the appeal. If your address is off, update that first, then submit the appeal. If you're not sure what to do or just don't want to do it, you can talk to someone like myself or lots of businesses, you know, some specialize in just helping with this. It's tough to get in touch with someone that, like a real person at Google, to actually help you there. But that's that. During the process, don't rush through it. Like, take your time. Have the documentation ready, because you only get a couple chances here. And if you fail both appeals, it's a little bit tough. You may just have to start over. So especially if you have a lot of reviews already built up, don't rush. Provide more evidence than's required. Take the time to write out a detailed explanation. Include links if you have like a link to your business license online, like if you have the actual business license plus the link there, like go above and beyond. It matters, especially if your business is dependent on local SEO. Don't submit multiple appeals. It's not really going to work for you. Don't make changes during review. So like make your changes, update the address, business name, whatever, submit the appeal, and then don't touch it. Let it sit until you hear back from the appeal. And then don't panic. If you're doing things the right way, this should work out for you. If you're doing things the wrong way and you're trying to trick the system, then you're rolling the dice. But if you're doing it legitimately and you submit the paperwork, like, it should work out for you. Key takeaways, and then we'll wrap up here. Don't make changes until it's resolved. Again, I guess make changes so that it's in compliance, then submit the appeal, then don't make changes. If you get suspended, don't panic. Just follow this process and you should get it appealed. Gather your evidence before you get started. Fix the violations before you submit the appeal. And then be patient. It can take 4 to 5 weeks. It sucks, but hopefully it goes quicker. We do see it go quicker in most cases, but just to be aware. And remember, prevention is better than reinstatement. So if you want to add, you want to do things where you're trying to bend the rules, then try to bend them the right way. Have a DBA for a business name that has keywords in it and so forth, and then you can be a little bit more protected there. All right, I hope this was helpful. If you have questions, if you want me to take a look at your profile, feel free to leave a comment and I will do my best to get back to that. I hope you all have a great day. Thanks for watching. I hope this was helpful. Talk to you later.